Okay, a balloon ladybug. There are several ways to do it. I'll show you two designs that I use. I didn't come up with them. I can't remember where I learned them. But these work for line work. So, first one, I use a black 350. Or a 260. Either one works. Make a round bubble. Pinch twist it, goes in, that'll be the face. And then four more round bubbles. So, and sometimes that happens when you're working. So you have to, if the lineup was big, I would just hand this to the kid and say, here, you make something, make a worm or something, and then I would start over. Because sometimes it's, once they let go like that, they're not going to hold properly afterwards, and I'd rather just keep things moving faster. Okay, so four bubbles, and you now have that, and then you get the kid to hold it. For this one, this is a round one with black dots on it. I'll see. And if you're trying to keep it secret, actually, you, don't show them that. Sometimes people say to surprise them, and I'll make something like this, hand it to them. And take out a round white one and put some air in it, twist it in half, twist it on like that. They still don't know what it is. Take a yellow 160, put some air in the end, just a little bit of air. And on my balloon bag, I have a little trimmer to trim the, it's an envelope opener, and I trim off the nozzle with that. And now we need some air at the other end here, so you stretch it out really well, like that, and then when you squeeze it, it should go up to there. And try to get them roughly even, doesn't really matter. Twist it in the middle, and then twist it around the eyes. The whole eyes and face area. So, at this point, you can let the air out of this. And I usually tie it. Leave that on, because that's how you make it into a wristband or put it on a flower or something. So, now you take the round red with the bubbles on it. And don't blow it up too big, not all the way at all. Because you're going to have to put a sidewall bubble on it, in the back. Just a small one. And you attach that bubble in the back to where these four bubbles meet. And then that string that's hanging down, that's where you just tie it to the back, tie it to there, and that's an attachment point for a bracelet or a flower. And you take your marker and draw on the eyes. I think it looks better with the big, big round eyes. And then I draw a line down the middle, down the back. And then that looks a little bit better, I think. So, that's one option. one option for ladybug. You can do the exact same thing using a heart balloon and make this part like one of the lobes of the heart. But I'm going to make a different one using a heart balloon, but just done up differently. This one I'll use a black 260. And you don't need the whole thing, so it doesn't matter how much you inflate it. And for this one, I do three pinch twists for the face. Well, sorry, one pinch twist and two small loops for the cheeks. And then four, I don't know, 1.5 inch bubbles for the body. Like that. And twist them together at the bottom. And then get someone to hold that for you. Round white for the eyes. Get them roughly split down the middle. Twist them into place. Another little bubble for the antenna. I mean, sorry, a 160 balloon for the antenna. And give it a small bit of air in it. Twist out the end. I mean, stretch out the end. Twist that in around the eyeballs. Now at this point, I grab a heart. And inflate it most of the way so that it actually has a heart shape. And tie it into the eyeball area. Anywhere there. Uninflate this. Bring it around the front. So it's around the, coming out where the eyeballs are. And you take this piece of balloon and you stretch it down over like the string. And it helps to make it flat. If it's kind of rounded or there's air in it, it doesn't like to stay put, it likes to roll. So make sure it's kind of flat. Pull it down. And tie it into the back of the four black bubbles. And pull it tight. So now, it's not tied or anything. Not yet. Just positioning it. It's already wanting to roll. So, gotta make sure that line goes down the center. And then you have to pass it through again or tie it or somehow secure it there. And then this extra bit comes back to the front. And tie it. And then for a little kid, that works for a bracelet. They don't have a really big hand, it works. Otherwise, I put it on, I just blow up a green balloon and stick it on there. And if I'm at a party, I'll make it a flower. And then you put on your artwork. And this one, instead of drawing a line down the middle, you put some dots on it. That works for ladybug. And I'll just put it on a stick.